हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। एज इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी लर्न अबाउट द डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन ऑफ गिवन नंबर्स। आफ्टर दैट वी लर्न हाउ वी कन्वर्ट अ डेसिमल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी अपॉन क्यू। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर टुडे we'll solve the exercise 1.3 of NCERT book. Clear? The first question is that write the following in decimal form and say what kind of decimal expansions each has. The question is, first 36 upon and as you know that the value of 36 will be 0.36, means it is terminating decimal. Terminating decimal. Yeah. Means if we divide 36 by 100, then after few steps of division, remainder will be 0. Hence, it is terminating decimal. Now, we check the second. Second one is 1/11. Second part is 1/11. We check it. 1/11. Clear? 0.0. And 11 9 0 0 and 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 11 9 0 0 0 11 9 0 0 0 11 9 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 1 by anyone, we get the quotient as 0.090909 and so on, means the remainder will never be 0 and 0 and 9 repeat itself, means that this will be non-terminating but repeating decimal. This will be non-terminating but repeating decimals, means 1 upon 11 equal to 0.09 bar. Non-terminating but repeat decimal. Clear? In this way, we check 4 whole 1 upon 8. Third, part is 4 whole 1 upon 8. 8 for the 32 and 33. 33 upon 8. Divide 33 by 8. 8 for the 32 1 decimal point 10, 8 1 ja 8 2 20, 8 2 ja 16 4 40, 8 5 ja 40. Means we can write 4 1 upon 8 equal to 33 upon 8 equal to 4.125. Remainder becomes 0. This will be terminating decimal. Yeah. Now we will check 3 upon 30. one has completed four and fifth part is third part, fourth part, fifth part and sixth part. We take this is up to your part 13. Next one is 2 upon 11 and next one is 329 upon 400. Clear? First 3 upon 13 we take it 330. 0.32 26 4 13 to 39 1 10. Here we increase 0 and 37 to 99 9. 36 to 78 10 120. 39 to 170. Clear? Now again 32 to 26 4 and 0. We see that 3 upon 13 is 9 terminating but repeating decimal, because we see that after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. After 6 digit, it will start repeats itself. Now, 3 upon 13 equal to 0.230769 bar. Clear? Not terminating. But repeat. Clear? Now we check the next one. 2 upon 11. 11 9 90 11 9 11 10 11 11 9 90 11 10 88 2 20 11 11 9 90 11 10 88 2. We see that this is a repeating decimal, that is 2 upon 11 repeat itself. Hence 2 upon 11 equal to 0.18 bar. Non-terminating but repeat RTPA, not a very good repeat. Now we check the last one. We can write it in this way, 4 into 100. First of all, we divide it by 4. 4 into 32. 4 into 8, 1. 4 to the 8. 4 to the 32. Now we divide 9. 4 to the 8, 1. We take decimal point 10. 4 to the 8, 2, 20. 4 times 20 upon 100. Means the decimal point will move left 2 digits. Means 0.8225. क्या हुआ ये? 329 upon 400. Terminate. TTR. This will be terminated. In this way, all parts of our question first is completed. Now we will discuss the second question. The second question is, you know that 1 upon 7 equal to 0.142857. Can you predict what decimal expansion of 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7? एंड सो ऑन आर वी नॉट एक्चुअली डूइंग द लॉन्ग डिवीजन इफ सो हाउ मीट इट
The question is that the value of one of our cells is given that the value of one of our cells is 0.142857 but we have to find the value of 2/7, 3/7 4/7, 5/7, and 6/7. The question is that can you find the value of all these results actual division? Yes, we can find because we can write 2/7 as 2 × 2/7. The value of 1/7 is given. Now. 2/7 is equal to 2 × 0.142857. Multiply it. The 2/7 is equal to 2 × 7 = 14, 2 × 5 = 1, 11 × 2 = 16, 17 × 1 = 4 × 5. 2 × 4 = 2, 0.8. In this way, we will find the value of 3/7. We can write 3 × 1/7 means so 3/7 equal to 3 × 0.142857 bar. Yes. Now we 3 × 7 = 21, 3 × 24 = 1, 25 × 3 = 62, 8 × 3 = 12, 7 × 3 = 4. Clear? 0.42857 The remaining parts of S 4/7, 5/7, 6/7 you can solve by yourself. Clear? Now we will discuss the third part of this question. Question number 3. What is the question number 3? The question number 3 is the express the following in the form of P upon Q where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. The first part is x equal to 0.6 bar. Second one is x equal to 0.47 bar and the third one is 0x equal to 0.001 bar. Clear? We solve it as in the previous two lectures. We will solve some examples in which we convert the repeating decimals in the form of P upon Q. We apply the same procedure to solve all these problems. First, we can write 0.666. We take this equation first. Now we multiply by 10 because here the integer of this is 1. 10 is equal to 6.666. Subtract equations first from second. Clear? 10x − 6 = 6.666 − 0.666. 9 = 6, x = 6/9, 3 × 6 = 9, x = 2/3. Means x = 0.6 bar = 2/3. This is the form of P upon Q where Q not equal to 0. Now this is the second. x = 0.47 bar. Clear? First of all, we multiply by the given number 10 so that the decimal point lies just before.
before the repeating digits. So 10 is equal to 4.7 bar. Now we can write it. If 10 is equal to 4 plus 0.7 bar, or 10 is equal to 4 plus bar se hum kya kar sakte hain 7 upon 9, as it is discussed in the previous lectures. Now we solve it. So 10 is equal to, we take here denominator 1, the LCM will be 9. 9 for the 36 plus 7. So 10 is equal to 36 plus 7, 43 upon 9. Our x equal to 43 till 9 the 90. 43 upon 90, we can write x equal to 0.47 bar equal to 43 upon 90. This is the formula P upon Q, where Q not equal to 0. Now we discuss the third. X equal to 0.001. Clear? Because the equation of 60, hence we multiply it by 1000. So 1000 is equal to 1.001001001. This is the second. Now we subtract first from second. 1000 is myself equal to 1.001001001 minus 0.001001001 means 1000 minus 1 is 999 years equal to 1. X equal to 1.0. X equal to 1 upon 999. In this way, all the three parts of question 3 is completed. Clear? Now, I will discuss the question number 4. We will discuss the question number 4. Why the question number 4? The question number 4 is that express 0.99981 in the form of P upon Q. Are you surprised by your answer with your teacher and his classmates? Discuss why the answer makes sense. Clear? Let us see this question. Question number 4. Given that x is equal to 0.9999 and so on, we have to convert it in the form of P upon Q. Clear? So we can write it as x equal to 0.99 means the refractional digit is 1. Clear? We write it x equal to 0.999. Now we multiply it by 10 both sides. So 10x equal to 9.999 equation 2, subtract 1 from 2, so 10x minus 6 equal to 9.999 minus 0.999. Clear? Now 9 is equal to 9.0, x equal to 9 upon 9, x equal to 1. This is an integer. Clear? The form of P upon Q of 0.999 is 1, which is a complete integer. Clear? Now, we discuss the next question, question number 5. What can the maximum number of digits be in the repeating block of digits in the decimal expansion of 1/17 half perform the division to check your answer. Page number 5. We have to check ki after how many digits the digit will repeat itself in the division of 1/7. We take it. 1 we have divided by 17. If you take that 6 times, then 17 6 will be 102, which is greater than 100. Hence, we take 5 times the table of 17. 17 5 is 85. 10 minus 5, 5. 9 minus 7 is, we take 0. 150. Now, 17 is 136, 10 minus 6, 4, 4 minus 3, 1, 14, again 17 is 136, 10 minus 6, 4, clear, 0, 17 to the 34, 6, 60, 17 is a 51, 9, 90, 75 is a 85, 5. In this way, you will proceed your division. Once again check, 17 times 85, 15, 150, 17 extra 136, 4, 14, 140, 17 extra 136, 4, 40, 17 to the 34, 6, 60, 17, 3 is 51, 9, 90, 17, 5 is 85, 5, 50, 17, 2 is 34, clear? 10 minus 4, 6, and 4 minus 3, 1, 160, 17, 9 is 153, 10 minus 3, 7, clear? 5 minus 5, 0, 17, 17, 4 is 68, 2, 0, 17, 1 is 17, 3, 30, again, 17, 1 is 17, 10, 7, 3, 13, 17, 7, 119, 11, 17, 6, 102, 8, 80, 17, 4, 68, 12, 2077 का 1191. You check that the number of digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. We see that it repeats after 16 digits. And the question is that after how many digits it repeats itself. In this way, the question number 5 is completed.